Hello everyone, this is Rohit. I welcome you to my YouTube channel. In this video we are going to learn how to find out cardinality of functions, how to find cardinality of function which are 1-1, means what, injective, how to find cardinality of function which are onto and bijective. Okay, so what I mean by that, so suppose I have two set, say set A, and I have another set, say B. Our A is domain and B is codomain, and suppose I have defined one function from set A to set B. Suppose there are m elements, say x1, x2 up to xn. Okay, and suppose in B I have y1, y2 up to yn elements. And so cardinality of A is m and cardinality of B is n. Okay, and I want to find out number of functions from set A to B. I also want to find out number of functions from A to B which are 1-1. I also want to find out number of functions from A to B which are onto and bijective. We are going to see all such formulas. So but before we go into formulas, let me recall what is 1-1 function, what is onto. So what is 1-1 function? Suppose I have two elements in codomain, say f of x1 and f of x2. If f of x1 and f of x2 both equals, then their pre-images. What is the pre-image of f of x1? Obviously x1. What is pre-image of f of x2? x2. Okay, if my images are equal, then their pre-images are also equal. This is 1-1. Then what is onto? What is onto function? If I take any arbitrary element in codomain, then I must get an element in domain whose image is that element. Okay, for example, if I take y element in codomain, and I must get some any element in domain, so for suppose say x, then whose image should be y. Okay, this is onto function. And what is bijective function? If my function is both 1-1 as well as onto, then we can say function is bijective. So let me define some function, say s1. Let me define some set, say s1. S1 consists of all functions from A to B such that f is function. Okay, so we have defined one function. Let define another set, s2. So s2 is a set consist of all functions A to B where f is 1-1. Okay, let's define one more set, s3, consist of all functions from A to B where f is onto. Okay, let's define one more set, say S4, consist of all functions from A to B where f is bijective. Okay, so these are the sets. Our aim is to find out cardinality of all four. So I will write formula for all four set and we will do problem based on this concept. Okay, but before we go into formulas, let me highlight one point here. So see, when do we say function is 1-1? When for two equal image I must get same pre-image. So in order to get same pre-image, what condition we should have on cardinality? The cardinality of B must be greater than A. Only then we can say 1-1 function exists. If this doesn't happen, then we can say there is no 1-1 function. Okay, same, if I want to found onto function, then cardinality of A must be greater than B, because we want for any arbitrary element Y, we are searching element in set A. Means what? For every element there must be one or more element whose image is that. Means what? Cardinality of A must be greater than this B. Okay, so this two point you must remember. In order to get one function, 1-1 functions, we must have cardinality of B greater than A, and in order to get number of onto function, our cardinality of A must be greater than B. Okay, so let me write formulas. So what is the cardinality of M? When we want to find out number of functions, total all possible number of functions from set A to set B, so how many such function will exist? So this is the formula: cardinality of B raised to cardinality of A. Means what? What is cardinality of B? B is n, and what is cardinality of M? sorry a which is equals to m. So there are n raised to m possible function from set A to set B. Next S2. Now see, I just told you, in order to get number of one function, cardinality of B must be greater. Means what? N must be greater. Okay, so m must be greater. And what will happen when m is greater than n? There will be 0 1 1 function. Okay, and what will happen when m is less than equals to n? There are n p m function. What is npm? Npm is nothing but permutation. And what is npm? What is npm? Npm is nothing but n factorial upon n minus m factorial. Okay, you remember this. Okay, now let's find out cardinality of set S3. See, for cardinality of S3, number of onto functions exist only when cardinality of A is bigger. Okay, so means what? Whenever cardinality of M is bigger, only then onto function exists. If my cardinality of M is small, then there is no onto function. Means what? Here, whenever M is less than N, number of onto function will be 0. Whenever M is greater than N, number of onto function will exist. And how many such onto functions will exist? So this is the formula: summation of R goes from 1 to N minus 1 raised to N minus R NCR R raised to M. So this is very important formula: minus 1 raised to N minus R NCR R raised to M, and summation runs over R from 1 to N. And this is happens only when M is greater than N, otherwise number of onto functions will be 0. Okay, next set is S4. And what is S4? All functions such that f is bijective. Now see, in order to we have bijective functions, means what? Function should be 1 1 from this side and this side also. Okay, means what? Cardinality of this set and this set must be equal in order to get number of bijective function. Means what? Cardinality of A and cardinality of B must be equal, only then we can find out number of bijective function. And what is the formula? Simply n factorial. Okay, so these are four formulas. These formulas are very important, and question can be framed on this topic in any kind of exam like CSIRnet, IIT JAM, TIFR, NBHM, anything. Okay, now we are going to see some problem based on these four formulas. Okay, so let's see one first problem. Suppose I have a set A as 1 2 3 4 up to n. Okay, and suppose I have a B as this, let's say simply A and B. Okay, and define one function from set A to set B. Okay, in this case, what is cardinality of A? Cardinality of A is n. Okay, and what is the cardinality of B? Cardinality of B is 2. Now see, if I compare this problem with this function, okay, so what is cardinality of A? Cardinality of A is m, no? Means our m is n. Okay, and what is our n? And our n is, means what? Cardinality of B is 2. Okay, so we are relating this problem with this problem. So m is nothing but n and n is nothing but 2, and we want to find out number of onto functions. See, why I am finding number of onto functions only, not 1 1? Because see, cardinality of A is bigger, means what? Only onto functions will exist. Number of 1 1 function will be obviously 0, because cardinality of codomain is smaller than cardinality of domain. Okay, so number of onto functions our aim is to find out. So how many onto functions will be there? Option A is 2 raised to 2m. Option B is 2 raised to n minus 2. Option C is 2 raised to n minus 2 raised to 2. And option D is, last option is 4 raised to m. And they are asking number of onto functions. So which one of these true? So what is the formula for number of onto functions? Summation R goes from 1 to n minus 1 raised to n minus r NCR R raised to m. Now see, what is our m here, our m is nothing but n, okay? And what is n? N is nothing but 2, okay? So our n is 2. What is our n? 2 minus r. What is again n? N means 2c r and r raised to m. M means our n, okay? Let's substitute r equals to 1 throughout. Minus 1 raised to 2 minus 1, 2c 1, 1 raised to n, okay? Let's substitute r equals to 2. Minus 1 raised to 2 minus 2, 2c 2, and 2 raised to n, okay? Minus 1 raised to 1. 2c 1 means what? 2. And 1 raised to n anyway will be 1. Minus 1 raised to 2 minus 2 will be 0, means 1. 2c 2 is again 1 and 2 raised to n. So what is the formula here? 2 raised to n minus 1 into 2 will be minus 2. So this many onto functions will be there from this set to this set. So which one of this true? So option B is correct, okay? Let's do one more problem. So suppose I have set A consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? I have 4 elements here. And suppose my base set, suppose my set B consists of this element A, B, C, D, and E. Now see, in order to evaluate number of 1, 1 function, cardinality of B must be greater than this set, okay? So see, number of 1, 1 or injective functions. So how many injective function will be there? So what is the formula? Whenever my domain set has domain set is bigger than codomain set, only then we can evaluate number of 1, 1 functions. So what is the formula? NPM. What is N? Is nothing but cardinality of codomain, which is equal to 5. And what is M? M is our cardinality of domain, which is 4, okay? So how many will be there? 5p4. 5p4 means what? 5 factorial upon 5 minus 4 factorial, okay? So 5 factorial upon 1, so 5 factorial will be 120. So how many 1 1 function will be there? There are 120 1 1 functions, okay? Now consider third problem. And suppose my set S is defined this way. Okay, this so function has domain and codomain both are equal, okay? In fact both are same. And suppose cardinality of my A is 6, then number of bijective function, number of bijective functions on A R. So first option is 524, second option is 726, third option is 720, and last option says none of the above. So which one of these two? Okay, they're asking number of bijective function. I have given how to find number of bijective function from set A to set B in which A and B are equal. In this what, A and A are same, okay? So what is the formula? Number of bijective functions. So what is the formula? N factorial, where what is N? Cardinality of A and cardinality of B both are equal, and which is equals to N. So here in this case N is our 6. So 6 factorial is what? So see, we have already evaluated 5 factorial, which is equals to 120. So for 120 into 6 will be 6 zeros are 0, 6 twos are 12, carry 1, 6 ones are 6, and this one 720. So option C is correct, okay?